Now, in case your internet has been disconnected by the Taliban, ever since he was banned from YouTube and from Facebook and from other platforms, EDP445 has been on the run. He has been fired from several jobs and he has been evicted from multiple establishments because, you know, people are going there and, you know, telling the people there to, like, not let him in. Like, he should not be there because he's a pedophile.
He's a pedophile. He's a danger to everyone in here.
Okay, so I just called security. Yeah. Go ahead and let security know all this information.
I will be more than happy to let them know. Thank you very much.
But it seems that EDP445 has found salvation in the form of Instagram, because recently it has been revealed that he has his own Instagram account with over 4,000 followers at the time of recording. The fact that he has an Instagram account means that he is not in prison, as many people have been suspecting. So today I thought, why not react to this Instagram account and see what it's all about? So the first post EDP made on his account comes just months after he was exposed as a pedophile. If you need any further, you know, proof that this guy does not feel remorse for what he did, this is it. This is evidence that this guy does not care about the fact that he was exposed as a pedophile, and the only thing he cares about is just keeping his brand. I mean, the brand is dead, but still, that's the only thing he cares about. He's that delusional. I just want to point out that all of the comments under his posts are disabled because he does not want people to remind him of the fact that he went into an alleyway expecting a cupcake, but instead caught a case. There's also a couple of videos and photos here that show EDP has been buying quite a lot of guns. I am not sure that it's a smart idea to invest what little money you have left into guns, but then again, this guy has the IQ of a beluga whale with cerebral palsy, so I'm not really surprised. He has also made this post which says, "A lot of people say they lost respect for me. I'm perfectly okay with that because trust me, the feeling is mutual," which once again proves that he doesn't care about what he did. God damn, this salsa is hot as fuck! And that looks like just the most disgusting salsa ever. It looks like he bought it at like some, like, you know, those ready meal sections in supermarkets and gas stations. It looks like he bought this salsa from exactly those places. And I mean, I'm not surprised. This guy, I'm not sure if he has much money left. So a salsa from a gas station or from a supermarket, it's fairly the only thing that he can afford. Fucking these pastrami fries up. Y'all want some? No, I don't. I'm pretty sure you spat in that dish before you started eating. Jesus Christ, look at all that ammunition. Like, bro, are you trying to protect yourself from the people who are, like, coming to evict you from your house or from your hotel room? Because I'm not sure if that's a good tactic to get the haters away from you. It just isn't. You know, just leave peacefully. There's no need for violence. The love and support will never be forgotten. Well, for you, it will never be forgotten. But for the people who used to support you, bro, they have moved on way past you. They don't care about you. They despise you, bro. All the times that they have watched your videos, they have taken those memories and they have thrown them out of the window. Because you know why? You know why they have thrown those memories out of the window? Because they no longer like you. They hate you for what you've done. You will never be forgiven for the fact that you tried to groom a child. Gonna be uploading a video soon trying this brutal shit. I've heard this shit is dangerous, but fuck it, I'm a dangerous guy. Lol, link to my channel is in the bio. And if we go to this guy's bio, the link isn't there, which probably means that his channel was deleted because, once again, you know, YouTube does not want a pedophile on its platform. Like, mate, why are you still trying to come back to YouTube? They don't want you on the platform anymore. Just move on, do something else with your life. Like, have you tried once again applying to, like, a normal job? I mean, I'm not sure if you'll be able to stay long there, but at least it's something. Like, you won't be as recognizable. Actually, no, you will, because you're such a fat ass. Dear God, I want to take a minute not to ask for anything from you, but simply to say thank you for all I have. Well, judging by the way your life has been going recently, it seems that God also doesn't like you, and he also doesn't want your gratitude. Overall, I say, looking at this account, it's just like turning off the life support of a cancer patient. It's just painful. I still don't understand how Instagram allowed them to create this account, considering they've actually banned a previous account that he has tried to create. So why is he allowed back on now? Like, what has he done to, you know, deserve being allowed back on Instagram? Like, has he, you know, donated to charity? Has he, you know, sucked someone off at Instagram? I mean, because it's EDP, most likely he did. But I just like to know, like, why has he, you know, got an Instagram account? And why hasn't it been banned yet? Now, of course, this being the internet, everyone on YouTube has found out about the fact that EDP445 has a new Instagram account, and there are already several videos up showing, you know, re-uploads of his videos, and once again displaying the fact that he literally doesn't care about what he did. So, thank you guys so much for watching this epic review on why EDP445 is a cringe individual. I'm not sure if any one of you knew that, but thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, and comment. Let's try to reach 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye. Disco, 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 disco. Disco. Disco, disco.